I will also advise people that are entering the new agey kind of scenario where you have a lot of this spiritual practice that are somehow misleading, and most of them also manipulated by the usual Jesuits, like the hexagram. Now, the whole thing brought by Gurdjieff. But go and study who is dealing now with this system and who has been behind this system now. And you will see the usual Jesuit, the fact that the Jesuits are even present in the New Age movement is not acknowledged by the New Ages, but they should wake up. If this information from the alien department, the planet techs, or whatever other spiritual practice is coming filtered from them, it's because there is a reason. They don't want you to perceive the real matter, the real reality, which
Well, what
is.
is the real reality then?
The real reality is that we are definitely in a constant fight between angels and demons, between the devil, Iblis, who represents the dark side, and God. Now, if we accept that everything in nature or around us is itself part of God and a representation of God, we are all emanation of God, or emanations of God. You are one emanation of God in this moment, he's another emanation of God in this moment. I'm, alhamdulillah, another emanation of God. Probably not the best, but at least I try. We all
Yes,
manifest.
absolutely.
You see, God has 1,001 names, many different ways of being.
Good and evil as well is our two
Good and evil,
sides to God.
absolutely, because Iblis itself, the devil, yes, but the darkest side of God, created itself by God. So obviously, there is no creation, neither in the dark or the white side, that is not part of God. Because God is the input, the starting input to this whole universal consciousness and also universal reality in the material plane. It was by an act of grace of God that we are here today in this little minimal infinitesimal planet in a lost solar system that we are here today talking
Sure.
like this. Why? But we have also our own history. We are reflections of God in many ways, and we have been granted the possibility of choosing where to go. We want to go towards God, or we want to go towards the darkness.
So tell me, your moment of realization in which you departed from being a member of the Illuminati, what happened to you? What made you change your mind?
See, it was in a very specific period of time in my life. I was actually, my wife was pregnant, waiting for my kid, that was after born, Isaac Rumi, alhamdulillah, very good. And he was born on the 7th of July 2006, and a very specific day, very symbolic also for me, because a year prior to that, I was in London just a week before what happened on the 7th of July, and I have to tell you that definitely the whole of London was flooding with psyops, and they were working all kinds of manipulation to pull off what they pull off that year, which was the terrorist attack in a tube station, an underground station, just a few one block away from where I used to live. I used to live in Leeson Street, just down the road from my jail. Also, basically, I could have been myself there. I could have been if I was actually just a few more days in London. But what I realized was that for a series of acts of grace, God has given me the possibility of still being here. In the year 2003, I started to clash with the Illuminati, especially the American side of the Illuminati, which was made up of a series of occultists, all very presumptuous, with various secret societies, all manipulated by the CIA in one way or the other, but still loyal to the New World Order plan in any way.
How did you disagree with them?
I disagree with them. Initially, I tried to find the possibility of a meeting. We wanted to celebrate the 1904 anniversary. What's that? The revelation that Aleister Crowley made in 1904 was the revelation of Ivas, the messenger of Parakrato, or the messenger of basically Horus, this god from ancient Egypt, that.
Horus.
Yes,
Horus. Okay.
he delivered the book that the Illuminati
Yes.
took somehow seriously, which was this book of the law, which is the biggest pile of rubbish in the world, but also is a very dangerous book. It's the heretic book that I would definitely, I don't see many books being so heretic, but if there is one that definitely has all the blasphemies, is the Book of the Law of Aleister Crowley.
Okay,
but also all the contrast, because this book says on one a beautiful word, like love is the law, love and the will, or each man and each woman is a star. Beautiful words, incredible. But then you have, on another phrase, terrible things, the law of the strong should prevail, Mary should be torn on the cross, Mohammed should be... Sorry, peace and blessings be upon him. Sorry for what I'm saying, because really what is on this book, the Book of the Law, is everything and the contrary of everything, which represents really the Luciferian character of Aleister Crowley. And the fact that he found many adepts for what was to come in the years after him. You see, Aleister Crowley managed to plant his seeds very carefully into America, in California, with the Parsons Lodge, which Hubbard became a member then after he founded Scientology. But he managed to plant his seeds very well, also in Canada. And through these seeds, a revolution came into being. That became after the New Age Revolution, because 10 years after the death of Aleister Crowley, William Burroughs and others were practicing at the Beat Hotel his rituals. And then years after that, we have the 1960s Revolution, which is a whole hymn towards Aleister Crowley's work, if we want. On many sides, it's been manipulated, the 60s, and I must say, very sadly, we have to understand that this manipulation went... especially for the people who are more innocent, who became victims of these gurus coming from India, were deliberately spread into the West with fake and false, showing a little bit of their techniques that obviously the Western man, because the Western man is now so distant from the spiritual reality and the possibility that the spiritual also becomes the material, so these two realities are connected. That's why, when before you ask me who is more powerful, the Pope or the President, well, the thing is, does the President die, the President of the US, or not? Yes, he dies. One day he will die. He can't be immortal, okay? So he has to meet death. Well, for him, to meet death without the approval of the Pope is to be basically scrapped off the map. Because they themselves are relying on those blessings and that network to bring their power to their successors, to the people after them, and to the people after and after.
So you're saying one hand of this washes the other. But to get back to your own realization and your own change.
Yes, it was.
You went against mainly the Illuminati.
Yeah, at the beginning, as I said.
How did you differ?
At the beginning, what happened was this. I wanted to see if it was possible to give a stop to certain practices of evocation of certain demons that were really dangerous for mankind. I thought at that point I could eventually move on the positive side of things. This movement, also the esoteric movement, which is very powerful also, and taking a lot of people within the New Age field and bringing them somehow towards the realization of something more positive. I thought that Aleister Crowley was definitely not positive, because he's not the way forward. Aleister Crowley has been put there for a purpose, which is to be the Beast. Now, the Beast is not the best character you have in the Apocalypse. So, in the transformation towards the end of time scenario, and the realization of a revelation that is something that people are waiting for. Everybody's waiting for 2012. Why they're waiting for 2012? Why? Because they are hoping that this will lead to somehow a cosmic consciousness and the unveiling of certain energy. And that's true. The manifestation of these energies upon Earth will be very strong, because the cosmic scenario, the alignment, the way the planets are coming together, the stars and the whole universe, is something that happens to be connected to the holy number of God. For the Illuminati, this number is 25920. 25,120. Part of it is 2,160. This becomes the change of an era. In Stonehenge, from the Eastern Gate, we will see the sun. That will be the moment of change for humanity. From a certain age, we enter another age, which is an age full of psychic power and of metaphysical strength. And we have to deal with it, but the powers that are on top of us, what I have been fighting now since I came out of it, is people that unfortunately want to use these powers to their own advantage. If the guy from the CIA will go to that grandmaster, to Lomar Duguet, for example, is a famous occultist in the US.